Hi, this is Peter Stanley. Welcome to my channel. Today we're going to take a look at the Vivosun VS1000 grow light. Alright, so yeah, Vivosun sent this to me for free to review. So let's take a look, go over a few things real quick. So it's got LM301H, which is one of Red's, the horticultural line of the Samsung diodes. They're pretty much built the same as the LM301B. They have an anti-sulfur coating. They've got 3,000 and 5,000K LEDs plus the 660 nanometer red. It's 100 watt grow light. It's dimmable, waterproof. It's IP65 rated, waterproof. And so let's take a look. So it's the box. Okay, so let me cut this open here. So we got instruction manual. Does have some grow room glasses. They protect you from the lights when you work with them. That's pretty cool. Most of the lights don't come with these. Some pulley hangers, rope hangers. Really well packaged. Let's see, here's the power cord. And the hanging hardware. I'll show you this when it's hooked up. I really appreciate that they've got a short distance from where it hangs to where you're rope hanger would attach to. Normally, like most of the grow lights I've seen, the hanging kits, like, you know, when you, if you hook it up to the pulleys, basically you're like hanging it this high from the tent, and you have to double and triple the hanging wires to get even close to this tight. So I really like that they did that. So this is the actual grow light. That's cool. So there's the dimming knob, and it looks like it dims at settings of 25 to 50. That's not like a variable. It's, you know, it goes from like 25 to 50 to 75 to 100, and all the way over is off. So that's cool. And driver is built into here, but this also has these vents on the sides for heat dissipation. You see, it's got a coating over the board here. All right, so I've had this plugged up for about 30 minutes at the highest setting, and it's pulling 97.8 watts. So it looks underneath. And for temperature readings, got this gun here. So across the top of the board, it's around 111. The little vent area, it's a little hot, higher. Well, it's around one, yeah, a little hotter. I guess that's where the heat's been dissipating. The top of the top of this is like just under 100 degrees, 98, 97, 98. So, yeah, so the average is around 112 for the board itself. So I used my Apogee MQ500 quantum sensor from Apogee Instruments to do some PAR readings and measure it in a 2-foot by 2-foot space. At the time I measured, I was getting 97.9 watts. Average PPFD was 505.31. Usable PPF is 187.78. And that gives me a micromoles per watt efficiency of 1.92. And I had this at a hanging height above the sensor at 9.25 inches. The very center PPFD measurement was 1017 at that height. Yeah, so it looks like a really efficient light for the amount of power it draws. I appreciate Vivosun sending this to me to review. I know there's like, you know, even with a top of the line sensor like the Apogee product, you know, there's going to be some, you know, minor things that affect the accuracy and consistency of these readings. But it's going to vary probably a little bit between reviewers depending on how they set theirs up. But I'll try to remain consistent the way I do mine, at least my that'll give you some reference. Yeah, so looks like a nice light. Hope you found that useful. Thank you very much for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe.